Hello, the purpose of this video is to show you how to customize the menu and dialog positions in LASTRADA to make using the software quicker and easier. This video is shot in a really high resolution, so I would suggest expanding to full screen so you can see all the menus and options that are being chosen. Okay, so what we're looking at here are two instances of LASTRADA stacked on my screen here. The top instance is an example of what a super user account might look like. As you can see, their menu has quite a few items, as well as I've set this menu to sit below this upper menu here. Down below, I've got an account that would be something like a technician would use, where they have six activities that they commonly do, and they've got a menu here that matches those activities. So essentially what these menu items do is I click a button, and when I click the button, a module launches for me. So here's the NCR module that was launched for me. I could have also accessed that module by coming over here to tests and modules and clicking on NCR. So for the purposes of this demonstration, we'll focus down here on this account. And this account is being used by a technician named Jill. So it looks like Jill works at an asphalt plant, and she tests asphalt as well as aggregates that are delivered to the plant every day. So let's say for the purpose of this example that Jill's company now wants to sample liquid binder deliveries to that asphalt plant. So Jill finds herself going over here to tests and modules, selecting asphalt binder, and then saying, look, I want to do receiving inspection. I want to basically take samples of binder that are being delivered to my plant. Just as a side note, asphalt binder can be treated as if it's coming out of a terminal in a refinery, and that would be accessed differently. So Jill does that regularly and decides that she wants to add a button over here so that she doesn't have to access this menu and do this every time she has to add a binder sample. So what she does, or what we do, is we go over here to options. We open up the general settings in options, and the general settings open for us, and it's showing us, displaying for us the results for Jill. So I'm going to go ahead and select, let's go ahead and use, look at Jill's settings in a way that allows us to modify them. Now keep in mind, we can also create settings for single people like we're doing here. We can do it for groups of people. We can do it for whole organizations, as well as corporations that might sit on top of individual organizations' subsidiary companies. So if you're going to do any of those other items, I highly suggest that you contact the LASTRADA Partners Help Desk, and we'll help you determine what's the best approach for establishing either default, corporate, or company-level configurations. Okay, so like I said, that we wanted to add, for Jill, we wanted to add a button or a menu item for her so that she could quickly access the binder receiving inspection. So we're going to go here, we're going to click on the seventh button, and I'm just going to call it binder. Jill likes to keep things simple, and so do I. So we also get the opportunity to create a tooltip, and what a tooltip does is when I hover over the button, it gives me a description. So I'm going to say, hey, look, if you hover over the binder button, it's going to say binder sample. And then the last thing is we have to tell the software what do we want to happen, or what module to be linked, to be opened when I click the button. So we've got a list of all the modules and submenus of modules that exist that Jill has access to. So before we went into testing tests and modules, asphalt binder, receiving inspection for binder. So I found the same thing on this menu here. And now I've told the software, look, we're going to create a button called binder. We're also going to give it a tooltip that says, hey, this is what you do for a binder sample. And then we've told the software what to execute. So I'm going to hit save and exit. The software is telling me I need to shut down the software and restart it for the changes to take effect. So we'll do that. So we're logging back in as Jill. So Jill's here. Now she's got a new button that says binder, and it pops up. Okay. So the other thing that we can do to really help speed up the use of LASTRADA and help things along as a part of your workday is position of dialog boxes. So previously, I'm going to assume that Jill had set up some dialog layouts that made sense for her. So she has a button here called HMA sample, and she has another button called aggregate receiving. And she runs with these two windows open all the time, so she actually doesn't even need to use the buttons more than once a day. She hits this button, she hits that button, and these windows are nice and tiled for her. And then she can keep adding samples on this window and never get out of it. But now we've asked her to do a seventh task, which is binder inspection. And when I click the binder inspection button, now this window pops up on top of everything. So to keep that view looking clean for Jill, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna reposition this box down here. And let's say we're gonna put it just to the left of the aggregate receiving inspection test as well. So now we really like this layout. So all we have to do to save this position of the dialog box is right click in the header. We get dialog settings. And in here, I'm gonna tell it to save the position and size of this dialog box. I had already previously done that for the hot mix sample, and I had done it for the aggregate sample over here. So now we've got a view that works really well for Jill, where she can get her asphalt samples, hot mix asphalt samples, she can get her aggregate samples, as well as polar binder samples, and she's not actually adding anything. She's working from the appropriate module, and all the modules are opened at the same time. So if we look at it from Jill's perspective, she comes in, she hits HMA sample, she hits aggregate receiving sample, and then she hits the binder button. And now we've got that layout that she would like to use, or maybe she wanted to use, in executing her work. Okay, thanks for watching the video. If you